Okay, I'd like to demonstrate now how we're going to make use of this spreadsheet inside this Excel Web Access web part. I just wanted to point out that you'll find step-by-step instructions for this, for what we're doing right now, in the DataLink for Excel Services guide that you'll find available with the class materials, either on your CD or available for download if you just go to the main page when you open your CBT and download the class materials. So this is where you'd find step-by-step instructions of everything I'm going to be doing right now. So we start by opening up a spreadsheet. And in this spreadsheet, well, we just want to make sure we've got some data link functions, or the whole thing's kind of pointless. We'll demonstrate something Microsoft can do, but it won't show you much about DataLink. And here we go. Here's something that we did in a previous exercise, this DataLink 5 exercise. We just did a production level report where we did some filtering with this PI sampled data option. So I'd like to make use of this. We're not going to be passing arguments or using named ranges now. That's something we do in our full web parts class if you're interested. But I just want to make sure that this is available somewhere where I can make reference to it within the web part page. And moving the spreadsheet onto the document library is pretty simple if you're working within Office 2007. You just click on this Windows button here, choose Publish, and within Publish you can choose Excel Services, and then browse through your network places. It's not always easy to find, but I'll go to the top level of my server here. And if I scroll down here, I can see, here it is. Here's my SharePoint site. Now I'm going to be putting this into not the Process Book Files document library. I'm going to put it into the same document library as where I store the web part page that goes with this particular spreadsheet. I just think it's better to keep them all together. So I would double click on that and go ahead and save this here. Now I do want to point out that I could have just as easily saved this locally and then uploaded this to the document library. So there's no real requirement that you do it this way using this particular publish option. Also, one more point. This checkbox is going to either force Excel to open this up in the web part page as soon as you finish saving this, or not. And I think in this case, I'll go ahead and select that just to show you what it looks like. I'll go ahead and save. It's going into that document library. You'll notice what happens is Excel is going to go ahead and launch a browser to look at that, look at that display. There we go. But that's not what we're interested in here. We're interested in putting it on a specific display. So let me close that out. And let's put this back where I've been putting all of my demo stuff. If you remember, I had a nice little demo page going here called My Web Part Page. I built it right at the beginning of the class. And I'm going to put this on there. So I'll scroll down, give myself some room here. Let's go into edit mode, and we'll add this. I think I'll add this to the very bottom, to the footer here. And this time, instead of going to the PI web parts, we look in the business data section here, and under Excel web, or under there, choose Excel Web Access. Now, as I pointed out, this is a Microsoft web part, so we did modify. Did some coding to make sure the DataLink works with it, but for the most part, this is Microsoft's web part here. Okay, there we go. Let me pick this up and move it down so it's a little easier to see. At the very bottom, there we go. Yeah, so you're presented with a wizard, but be honest, I really don't like those wizards because they keep changing from one version to the next. Whereas we tend not to change this method, so let's go and use this method. I'm going to go ahead and modify this shared web part by going in here. You can see the options as well. We're going to go in here and specify the name of the workbook. So the workbook is what I had uploaded to my, I put it into the CBT demo docs. If you remember, that was the document library that contains it. And here it is. And we can choose, what we display. In this case, it's showing 75 rows. I can increase this, decrease this as I choose to. And I can also control the types of things that are happening here in terms of recalculation. All these kind of options, the size, the shape, etc., all that's available. So for example, if I want to make this larger, I go ahead and say let's make this 700 pixels. I'll go ahead and say OK. And you probably can't see it, but oh, there we go. It updated awfully quick. Let's go into build or out of build mode into run mode. Can't really see it, but that was refreshing this screen. And there's our report now. Now again, this is a web page, so you don't have the option here to edit. If you stick around for our full Web Parts class, the PI Web Parts class, we go into details on how you can actually add parameters and pass parameters to this from one web part to another to actually change those values. Alternately here, you can choose Open in Excel, and then from there you can go ahead and make your changes and save it, just like what we did with Process Book.